So I'm sure all of you guys are familiar with the idea that we require a minimum of 3 nodes to form a Nutanix cluster. Now, if you have been following our recent features, we had come up with a single node cluster in your previous major release, AOS 5.5. With our latest 5.6 release, we bring to you 2 node clusters. I recommend you watch the single node cluster video first if you haven't done it already. You should see the link below. Hi guys, welcome to another video of Tech TopX. Quite similar to the single node cluster, the 2 node clusters are also designed for robo implementations that require a lower cost and yet higher resiliency. However, it provides more of the resiliency features of a 3 node cluster that you're more familiar with. RF2 for data is spanned across 2 nodes, meaning the cluster can tolerate a node failure. During an AOS upgrade or a hypervisor upgrade, the user VMs will still be functional. The key difference here is that there's an external witness VM that must be run in a separate failure domain and serves the purpose of a tiebreaker. So let's go over the architecture a bit, which will clarify this. So this is the 2-node cluster with A and B being the 2 nodes, and here's a witness VM. Now Genesis on both the nodes send heartbeat messages every 2 seconds, and both the nodes contact the witness VM at 60 seconds apart. And this is the normal state. The way it works is, if in case of a failure, like a network disconnect or a node failure, and Genesis times out for more than 10 seconds, the 2-node cluster transitions to a single node state. So let's say there's a network disconnect. And Genesis times out. So now what happens here is that both the nodes A and B request for leadership from the witness VM. And the witness picks one of the 2 nodes as the leader. So let's assume A becomes the leader here. So now there are a few steps that follow this. Now since A is the leader, A is going to initiate the transition to a single node mode. So what happens here is that Zookeeper restarts in standalone mode. And both node A and node B catch that node A is the leader, and node B is going to shut down all of its services except Genesis. Genesis is going to update Zookeeper that the cluster is going to a standalone state. Following this, Cassandra sees this update and detaches node B from the metadata ring. Once the metadata has all been migrated to node A, next, Curator would migrate all the actual data to the local disks in node A. And then the transition to a single node is complete. So let's say the network connectivity has been restored, and now Genesis on both nodes A and B can talk to each other. So essentially what happens is that the cluster transitions back to a 2-node state. Now the transition back is pretty slow because we want to ensure that the heartbeats are stable. Usually it takes up to 15 minutes. And the process is pretty much the reverse of the failure scenario. Zookeeper restarts, and we update Zookeeper with the intent to switch back to the 2-node state. Node B gets added to the metadata ring, and Cassandra migrates some of the metadata from node A to node B. And now the actual data starts getting replicated from the disks on node A to the disks on node B. Curator takes care of this. And finally, when all the services have completed, the leader is removed. And this brings it back to the normal state. Now let's jump over to a quick demo of how this is done. This is Prism with the same interface that you're familiar with. I'm trying to log in. Notice that right away it asks you to configure the witness VM. Now I have already created a witness VM here. So as you can see, there are just 2 hosts in this cluster. And this is the witness VM configuration. You can see that this cluster has been registered now. You can use the same witness VM as in Metro if you use that feature, or it can be downloaded from the support portal. Now jumping over to the command line of node A, this is in the normal state now.
as you can see, the metadata is equally distributed between the two nodes. Now, I'm going to simulate a failure scenario by creating a network disconnect between the two nodes. This is node B. Now, with this command, I'm going to add a delay of 12 seconds for all the packets going out of E0 on node B. Now, there's going to be a delay of more than 10 seconds between node A and node B, and Genesis is going to time out. Now, as you can see that in the witness page, there is an update that one node is down, which is node B in this case, and node A has been picked as a leader. So now the transition to single node mode can take up 30 to 60 seconds. The client VMs can experience IO timeouts during this period, and Prism will also be inaccessible for a bit. Jumping back to node A, if you look at the transition change here, you see that a leader has been picked, which is node A in this case, and the cluster is operating in standalone mode right now. If I run the node tool command again, I see that node B has been removed from the ring, and node A owns 100% of the metadata. Now I'm going to reset the delay in node B. So now the cluster will transition from the single node state back to the two node cluster. As I mentioned before, this transition will take a longer time as we want to ensure the heartbeats between the two nodes are stable. And if it's been stable for 15 minutes, the failback is initiated. Now that we have waited for a sufficient time, let's go check the Zookeeper configuration. You can see the transition changes here. This was what we saw before when it transitioned to the standalone mode. And now you can see that it has switched back to the two node state and back to a normal state here. You can see that node B has been added back to the ring and the metadata is equally distributed between both the nodes. Can see all the services on both the nodes are up. Please note that it'll take significant time for the data to get replicated onto node B's disks. So once that is done, the leader will be reset and you should see the update on the witness VM.
So that is a demo of how the feature works. Like the single node cluster, we do have a few limitations. This is supported only on the NX1175S G5 platforms. Today, only AHV and ESX are the hypervisors supported. You will not be able to expand the cluster to make it a three-node cluster. Also, features like dedupe, erasure coding, and AFS are not supported today. So that's all for this episode. Check out the other videos on our 5.6 release. As always, be sure to subscribe and leave a comment. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.